Hi students, see I'm here to teach you about interrogative pronoun. What? Interrogative pronoun. Yes, see let's start our class. Interrogative pronoun. What does mean by interrogative pronoun? What is pronoun first? Pronoun. That is, it replace your noun. Yes, pronoun. That is, pronoun always replace your noun instead of noun. Yes, so that is pronoun. That is three persons. Or consider as what? Pronoun. Yes. So we are going to learn about that is interrogative pronoun. What does mean by interrogative? See, by seeing the word itself, we can understand interrogative means that is question type, right? So raising questions instead of that is in front of others. Yes. So raising questions in front of others. That is interrogative. It always indicate with question mark. Yes. It always indicate with that is question mark at the end of the sentence. Yes, we should use question mark at the end of the sentence, right? So this is the rule. See, this is used to ask questions and to replace a noun. Yes, so interrogative pronoun used to ask, that is used to raise questions and to replace a noun. Yes, so that is the interrogative pronoun. See, what are the interrogative pronouns we have? See here. That is five. Yes, five question words are here. See, what are the words? What, whose, which, who, whom. Right? See, let me repeat. What, whose, which, who, whom. Yes, and these words will indicate the, that is question mark at the end of the sentence. Yes, let's see some example by using these words. What are you searching? What are you searching still? So what are you searching still? Yes, we used to ask questions, no? So what are you searching still? Yes, I am searching my book. Yes, that is the answer. That there is anyone answer like that. Yes, if you ask, if you raise any questions to others, means they need to answer you, right? So what are you searching still? I am searching my book. I am searching my note. I am searching my pencil. Yes. Next, whose book is this? Yes, whose pen is this? You used to ask like that. Yes. So whose. So it always refers anything, yes, anything or anyone, yes, it may be a thing or a person. So whose book is this? Whose book is this? Yes. So if I ask like this, means what will be the answer? Whose book is this? It's mine. See here, it's mine. Mine. See the word mine. Mine indicating what? See, mine refers to what? That is a possessive pronoun. Possessive. In possessive case, we will use this mine. Yes. So here it is showing what? Ownership. Yes, relationship. That is ownership. Owning his thing or person. Yes. Anyhow, it is showing here ownership there. Yes, it's mine. So whose book is this? It's mine. So this is a possessive pronoun. Next, which? Which is your native place? Which is your native place? So, do you know all about your native place? No? Yes. See, if anybody asks you which is your native place, what will you give the answer? See, our answer will be, we will answer what? That is, my native place is Chennai. My native place is Madurai. Yes, whatever it is. Yes, so according to your native place, you will answer. So, which is your native place? So, Chennai is my native place. Yes. So, Chennai is name of the place. So, it is indicating what? It is giving with a noun. Anyhow, it is explaining with noun. Yes, so that is a pronoun, that is interrogative pronoun. Yes, so which is your native place? Chennai. Which, instead of which, instead of which I am using, that is I am putting Chennai. So here Chennai is what? Chennai is a name of a place. Yes, so anyhow it is a noun. Anyhow it is a noun. So Chennai is my native place. Yes, so that's it. Next, who? Who is your? Who is your favorite person? Students, look at the sentence. Who? See, by using who, see, we have formed one sentence, that is, who is your favorite person? Yes, who is your favorite person? Somebody will ask you, see, who is your favorite person? Who is your favorite friend? Say, yes, who is your favorite poet? Yes, so we used to ask like that. What will you give the answer? Who is your favorite person? My favorite person is my father. Yes, or my father is my favorite person. Yes, my father is my favorite person. Yes, whatever it is, we are mentioning our favorite person instead of who. Yes, so who refers to what? Person. Yes, who means it always indicate the person. So who is your favorite person? Or the actor, who is your favorite actor? Anyhow, it is insisting what? Person. Yes, next, whom. We are talking about the whom. Whom, with whom, let me write one example. With whom did you go to the fair? See, look at the sentence, students. With whom did you go to the fair? That is book fair. Yes. With whom did you go to the fair? What will be the answer here? See, with, that is along with my friend. Yes. With my friend, I go to the fair. Yes. With my friend, I go to the fair. Or I go to the fair with my friend. So anyhow, it is right. Both are right. Yes. So with my friend, I go to the fair. Or I go to the fair with my friend. Both are same. Both are right. Yes. So this is the formation of sentence by using these questionary words. Yes. So anyhow, interrogative pronoun is always explains about the questionary sentence. Yes. It is used to raise questions, raise queries in front of others. Yes. They are in need to answer us. Yes. So this is used to raise questions in all the situation. So whatever the situation may be, we can use these words for raise questions. Yes. So according to the situation, we can use the question words. Yes. So that's it, students. These are all the interrogative pronouns. Let us recall that. What, whose, which, who, whom. Yes. So these five words are all the interrogative pronoun. Yes. So these are all the examples. And what is interrogative pronoun? This is used to ask questions. It is used to raise questions and to replace your noun. Yes. So it is the formation of queries. Yes. So that's it, students. Thank you. Thank you for being a part of this session. Thank you.